Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the linear search process. In general, we have four steps to consider. The first step is to start from the first index of a list in order to find out your target. And the second step is to see whether the element from that index equals the target. Third, if it does not equal the target, I increase the index by one so that I go to the next element. And after that, I do the repetition of steps 2 and 3 until a number is found that equals the target or the final index is checked. If the final index is also checked and we still haven't found the target from the list, we say that the value is not found from the search. Let us see an example. Suppose I want to search from these numbers and my target is now 2. That means I want to find out 2 from these 5 numbers. What will be the process of the linear search? The first thing is to set up the index to be 1. 1 refers to the first element, which is now 4. And I'm going to compare the first element, which is number 4, with the target, which is 2. And now we see that the current element, which is 4, is not equal to the target, which is 2. So 4 is not equal to 2. It means that the target is not found from the list. In this case, we increment the index. Now the index is incremented to 2. That means I'm trying to see whether the second element equals the target or not. The current element is now 5, and the target is now 2. So 5 is not equal to 2. In this case, we can say that the target is not yet found. We have to increment the index again. Now the increment is done so that the index becomes 3. And now I'm going to check the third element to see whether it equals the target or not. The current element is 1 and the target is 2 and they are not equal to each other. In this case, the target is still not found and we have to increment the index again. Now the index is now 4, which is just 3 plus 1. And the current element is going to check with the target. And we see that the current element is equal to the target. That's why we have 2 equals 2. In this case, we can say that the target is really found from the list, and the search is now complete. That means we have really found the target from the list. Let us see another example. How about finding out 6 from the list of these 5 numbers? We start with index 1, which is the first element, and we see that the current element, which is 4, is not equal to the target, which is 6. In this case, we say that the target is not found from the list. That's why we have to increment the index. Now the index becomes 2, and we want to see whether index 2 element is equal to the target. The current element is 5, but the target is 6, so they are not equal to each other. In this case, we say that the target is not found from the list. That's why we have to increment the index again. Now the index is 3. So I check the third element with the target, which is 6. The current element is 1 while the target is 6. In this case, they are not equal to each other, and we have not found the target from the list yet. That's why we have to increment the index. Now index becomes 4, and I'm able to see whether element 4 equals the target. The current element is 2, but the target is 6. That means we have not found the target from the list yet, and we have to increase the index by 1. Now the index becomes 5, and the target is still 6, of course, and the current element is 3, but the target is 6. It means that we have not found the target from the list yet, and we have to increment the index. Now the index is now 6, which is already beyond the largest index of your list, which was 5. So the target has nothing to compare with. We can see that the index is already out of bound. In this case, we can say that the target is still not found, even the index is already out of bound. So we have to say that the target cannot be found from the list. And of course, after going through the entire list, we can say that the search is complete and in this situation, we cannot really find the target from the list. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your comments at the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.